Hi everyone, it's Vicky here with an art journal project today. Today I plan to use these die cuts by Pebbles, but first I will be working on my background. I am going to color the background with distress paint. I have chosen the color Wild Honey and I will apply it with my baby wipe. And now I am going to show you a super fun technique for the background. I am using glaze. This is a product by Faber-Castell. It looks like glossy accents, but it's more liquid and I can apply it with a spatula. I am going to use this stencil with all those little tiles and I will apply glaze all over it. The end result is going to look like tiles on a wall. And as always, you can find a full list of all the supplies that I'm using today just below the video in the description area, as well as on my blog. Glaze dries transparent, but at the same time leaves a nice gloss on your project. It does take a few minutes to dry, so once I did the whole background with my glaze, I left it aside to dry and I went to something totally different. Don't mess with it, because you will ruin the effect. I covered up the whole background and then I left it aside to dry for about half an hour. It does dry quicker than that, especially if you don't apply it too much, but I needed to be safe than sorry. Now my background is dry, so I will be using my blending tool with distress ink and I will go all over my background. The ink that I am using is a Vintage Photo. Glaze resists distress ink, so the ink goes only where there is no glaze. I am going to apply my distress ink all over the both pages and then I will be using a cloth to wipe off all the excess ink that stays on top of those tiles. I just love the effect and I think that this is a great technique for backgrounds. So this background that I created today is supposed to be a kitchen wall, as I am making a kitchen themed layout. And here is the bag with those die cuts by Pebbles. I got this in Simon Says Stamp November card kit, but you can get it separately. You will find a link down below in the details area. So I am separating those dies because if you check, there are some of them that have a white border around them and others that don't. So for my layout today, I want to use only those die cuts that don't have that white border. So I'm actually making two different piles with the ones I want to use and the ones that I don't. Using die cuts such as this or bags with ephemera are a really great solution for creating art journal projects because not only they give you ideas and inspiration, but at the same time you can finish a project super quickly. So now I am trying to decide which ones I will be using on my layout and I will try to place them on my page and see where everything is going to go. Once I am happy with the placement, I will go ahead and use my gel medium to stick everything down. I have also cut out those strips of paper from wood grain paper and these are going to be shelves for my kitchen. So now it's time to stick everything down with my gel medium. If you are wondering how I can remember where everything is going to go, I have just used my tablet and took a photo once I was happy with their placement. Use your mobile phone or your tablet, take a photo, and you can refer to it if you can't remember where you wanted to place everything down. For the oven mitten as well as the cutting board, I want to place them as if they are hanging from that shelf. So for the mitten, just because there is that white area, I don't want that to show, and I will be using my craft knife to cut it out. And then I will go ahead and stick them as if they are hanging from their loops. Now everything is nice and dry, I am using my scissors to cut out the excess, and now it's time for shading, which is going to help and to bring everything together. For my shading, as usual, I'm using my big brass markers by Faber-Castell, and I am using a slightly darker color than each image that I am shading, and I add some shading on the inside of the design. Then I will go ahead and use a dark brown and go all around the outside edges. If you are creating projects inspired by my work, I would love to see them because this really makes my day. After all, that's why I share everything on YouTube. So once you post them on your social media, whether it's Facebook or Instagram or your Pinterest or everywhere else, make sure to use the hashtag inspired by Vicky so I can find your work and leave your comment. I have finished with my shading, so I will go ahead and use a thin black marker and go all around the edges. I am not drawing perfect lines, I just want them to be sketchy, and this is going to make it as if I have drawn everything myself. Also, you need to remember that before you start writing on top of gel medium, like I'm doing here with my marker, or like I did previously with my big brass markers, gel medium has to be dry. Otherwise, it will ruin your markers because gel medium is actually glue and it will stick on everything. Now I'm adding some highlights. To do so, I'm using my white gel pen. And what is great about using this gel pen is that if you don't like the highlights, you can wipe them off with a baby wipe, just because I am working on a gel medium covered area. I just love the look of highlights on my projects with my gel medium, and that's because I think it gives a nice and cartoonish look. So I keep doing it again and again on all my projects. To make my pages more interesting and to add texture, I like to add different elements. So at the moment, I am going to add a couple of brads from where my cutting board and my mitten is hanging. And that's the great thing of not working back to back on your projects, because this gives you the flexibility to make holes or anything else that you can think of. And at the end, you can always use some glue and stick all those pages together. I am also going to add a wood veneer heart on the cutting board. I have used gel medium to stick my little wood veneer heart on the cutting board, but you can use any type of white glue to do that. All that's left to do now is to stamp the quote. For my quote today, I am going with Season Everything with Love, which I am going to stamp at the very bottom of my page using this alphabet stamp set. This is a stamp set by Simon Says Stamp, which is called Grunge Alphabet, and I am using black archival ink to stamp my quote. To finish off my project, I will stamp the date. And again, I am using black archival ink. So that was the project for today. I hope you had fun and got inspired. And if you did, don't forget to leave me a comment as well as give me thumbs up on my YouTube channel. Here are some close-up photos of my project today. If you haven't subscribed to my channel already, make sure to do so, because this is the way to tell me that you love my videos and you want to see more. And if you need more inspiration, here are two more art journal projects. Click on any of them on the screen right now, or if you are watching from a mobile device, then you can find links to those videos just below in the description area. Thank you all for watching!